why you want to take them.
Uber. How many of you have heard about Uber? Okay. Have you heard about Uber? Great. Everyone. How many of you have Uber installed on your phone? Cool. So Uber, what is Uber? Uber lets you to get a taxi, share rides, or have a car from your mobile phone. It connects you with a driver nearby within minutes. It is very convenient. Think about it. In your Chicago winter, of course, that night, just at night, you are hanging out with your friend in a restaurant, it snows, and you finish dinner, you're waiting outside, the wind just blows on your face, it's freezing cold. You're waiting there for 10 minutes, and those taxis pass and pass with dim lights because nothing is, they're all vacant. You're waiting there for 10 minutes. It's not a good feeling. But with Uber, you don't have to get outside at all. You can sit in the restaurant with your friend, pull out of your phone, order Uber, and it shows the driver is 3 minutes away. Then you can spend another 3 minutes with your favorite friend. Well, once the Uber arrives, it notifies you, hey, the driver is here. You get out on the car, stay warm, and boom, you went home seamlessly. That is very nice, right? So besides the convenience, the other thing you may like about Uber is the payment of hassle-free. Have you guys been in a situation that you're in a taxi, it turns out that the credit card machine breaks down and you have to pay cash? Chances are you might not have enough cash. It happens to me. It happens. It's a horrible, horrible experience. One time I took a taxi to work. The driver is about 60-year-old American guy, and he had a poker face. Don't really, like he just drive, he don't really talk to me, he don't smile. When it arrives, of course, the credit card machine breaks down. At that time, it's not, I don't have enough cash, it's I have too much cash. All I have is $100 bill. I don't know what happened on that day, but that's all I have. And I hand it over to him, it's like, this is all I have. And he looks at me in an unbelievable face, almost shouting. What do you think about throwing back $100 bill at me in early morning where I did not collect enough cash yet? I'm like, oh, sorry, but that is all I have. It turns out that he do have enough changes. He just do not like to count all the smaller bills, and he keeps cursing and took the change to me. And I was just had enough. So I'm like, I want all my changes back. No tip, zero tip. Because that is not the level of service that I'm expecting for. And he, of course, he got very angry. When I get out of the car, he's shouting at me, with throwing back things back at me, the sarcastic and racist, he's like, welcome to America. It's really bad experience. You guys don't want to experience that at all. With Uber, you don't have to deal with all of it. The credit card is linked to your account. You don't need to deal with the payment, the awkwardness of paying tip. Just get out of the car and let the internet to take care of the rest of it. So I use Uber like a lot. After Uber was invented, all my money that I pay taxi just boom, went straight to Uber driver's pocket. And one day it turned out that I have to take a taxi because I was late for gym class. I don't have the extra time to wait for 3 minutes. So I took a taxi, when it arrived, because I'm late. So I just opened the door and run. That you are late for class, what do you do when you are late, right? So I open the door and I run. The driver is like chasing after me and beeps at me, rolling down the window. He looks at me like, you didn't pay. I look back at him, I go, wait, what? It took me 3 seconds to realize, oh, I'm in a taxi, not Uber. So we cover convenience, the payment has a free, oh, that one most important thing is the price. So at a normal rate, Uber is about 40% cheaper than a taxi in Chicago. What does that mean? 40%. 40% means that if you take 3 taxi rides, the same amount of money can pay for 5 Uber rides. So either take 3 rides, you save money, or you take 5 rides, you save time. So customers love Uber. That's why the demand is high and supply is high. there are about 15,000 Uber cars on the street of Chicago nowadays. There are a group of people who hate Uber. Guess who?
Taxi drivers.
Yes, Ken's right. Taxi drivers hate Uber. And you know what the smart ones, I mean the ones that knows how you talk to use a smartphone, probably already get converted. So the rest of the taxi drivers just hate Uber more. In London, it actually happened that so when Uber first entered the market, the Uber cars parking on the street, their tires get damaged by taxi drivers. So it's not only about hate, they took actions. In the US, taxi driver companies, they work together to lobby the government. That's why Uber is not allowed everywhere in the US. In cities like Las Vegas, it is banned. So in Las Vegas, you can only own a taxi, not Uber. Of course, I am excited to see taxi drivers who work hard and long hours end up earning less. But rationally, I think that's what it happened when an industry undergoing dramatic change. What are the good things about Uber in social responsibility? More women drivers. You see substantially more women drivers in Uber than taxis because technology, they can use a GPS. And more flexible time for moms that they want to take care of their children. They can have that time to do those things they like. The other thing about Uber is algorithm. They have Uber Share and Uber Pool. And for example, how you wanted to go to the North Avenue to see the water, air and water show and sort of tip. You guys just happen to be two blocks away and you order Uber at the same time. The algorithm is going to figure out that you guys going to the same location. They pick you guys up and go to the North Avenue. You pay half of the price that you should be. What does that mean to society? Less car, less gas, and better environment.